Welcome back, our viewers. It's a continuation of our discussion on the role of women in politics. Karibu sana.
Present.
Okay, Mr. Bisai, you are still explaining a point about marginalization of women. Please, carry on.
Yeah, women in all over the world are the most poor, the most vulnerable, the most hopeless in any community you go to. And for obvious reasons that our societies have been matriarchal majorly. And that means that the owners of wealth are men. Women play, like we just take a village for instance, a woman wakes up very early, tills the land, raises the animals, feeds them, harvests the maize and put in the home. The man comes and sells and takes the money to go and drink. That is what culture allows the man to do. But the fact is, who was producing, who was working the whole of the year? It was the woman. The man was in an urban area, he had gone to look for a job, which he didn't find. And he comes home, he gets a herd of cattle, which he has never taken care of. He gets some harvest in the granary, and he decides to sell, and he goes to drink the money or spend it with other women. And the wife, who worked very hard to produce this wealth, is given no regard at all. That is the easiest way to explain how the culture marginalizes a woman, and she accepts without question.
Mr. Mood.
What I have to say, I think when you talk about some prevalences, special prevalences that has to be, you know, given to women, I think in some cases, in some situation, that is okay, because you remember even from the old days, we have heard of the is it chivalry or chivalry?
Chauvinism.
No, chivalry.
Chivalry,
where you are supposed to give women special preferences. You are supposed to take all men are supposed to take, you know, to give him some to take care of them and help them. And it is not only women but children. So it is right when women say they are supposed to be accorded some special privileges, because as my colleague, my friend is saying, many a time the system has not been fair to women. And when you find yourself in a system that is not fair to you, the only fair thing should be that people should do something about you to help you to catch up with the rest of the society. So I think the society should do more to reform and be able to help women to catch up with men. And there shouldn't be feeling that, we are helping women, you know, to defeat men.
Okay, but Mr. Bisai, do you agree that women can redeem themselves?
Women cannot redeem, a slave cannot redeem himself. That has never happened. When we have had the clear cases of slavery in the US and the rest of the world, it took the free to liberate the slaves. Similarly, anybody who is a victim of alienation or marginalization cannot liberate himself without those in power realizing the injustice and taking the cause to provide remedy. Although they can fight, because now through education, those who are seeing, and through advocacy, and through other social campaigns, the voice of the people can begin to be raised. But it's up to society itself to realize that in the interest of the common good, the woman has been enslaved for far too long and needs to be liberated. And therefore, when you hear people saying, let us come out with equalization or affirmative action or some other methods of positive action to liberate the women from the yoke, we know affirmative action does not woolly. It just gives a role model. It does not actually liberate, but it gives an example to the others below, and it gives the society to rethink the values that they have attached to some action they do. So if we really have to help our women folk, we must rethink our value systems, and it takes those who are free to liberate the women. Do not expect Mama Mboga to liberate the other Mama Mboga or the women rape. You say, why didn't you vote for the women rape and yet she's a woman? You understand, because a woman in a society does not exist in her own space. She exists in a social space that is dominated by men. The values of that social space are defined by men. And what goes on in that space, social space, is defined by men. So whatever action is going to happen is not going to be free action of women. It is going to be the voice of men. So women will continue to sing and speak as men do in every society. So we need to have affirmative action on every front.
Thank you so much, gentlemen.
Yeah.